So this is all about the structure of anatomy in dicot primary root. Similar to this, if you are going to study and compare the anatomical structure of monocot root, then monocot root show maximum similarities with the internal structure of dicot root. For example, in case of monocot root, epidermis is very similar to the epidermis of dicot root. That is, epidermis is single layered, compactly attached, rectangular parenchyma cell, and tubular root hairs are arises as the extension of epidermal cell. Secondly, just below the epidermis, cortex is present like the cortex of dicot root in case of monocot, and cortex also consisting on circular loosely arranged parenchymatous cell with abundant intercellular spaces to transport the water. Endodermis is also present, and the cells of endodermis also contain two types, that is, some cell have the deposition of suberin, that is Caspian strip, and they are impervious or hydrophobic to the water. Some cell of the endodermis just next to the protoxylem did not have the deposition of suberin. They are not made up of Caspian strip, they are passage cell, and passage cell easily allow to transport the water from cortex into the protoxylem. The main difference between the monocot root and dicot root is the presence of number of vascular bundle. Point to be noted that in dicot root, the vascular bundles are found to be in 2 to 6 patches. 2 to 6 or 2 to 4 patches. That is, in dicot root, the vascular bundle are diarch or tetrarch. However, in case of monocot root, the vascular bundle are found to be in many patches. Vascular bundle are generally found to be in 6 patches or more than 6. That is, you can say that in case of monocot, vascular bundles may be minimum 6, that is hexarch, or more than 6, that is vascular bundle are polyarch. Next difference in dicot root and monocot root is, in case of dicot, pith is very small and inconspicuous, whereas in case of monocot root, this pith is very large and conspicuous. So first difference in vascular bundle, second difference is present in the pith. In monocot root, pith is larger and conspicuous, that is, well developed pith. So these are the main differences. Next thing, you know that in monocot, cambium is not present. That's why monocot stem and root both could not show the secondary growth. In case of dicot, cambium is present in the form of wave shape structure. So dicot root can show the secondary growth, and secondary growth could not be occur inside the monocot root. So third difference is here according to the secondary growth. No secondary growth is taking place in the monocot root. So this is all about the anatomical comparative structure of dicot root as well as monocot root. In the next slide, we are studying the comparative structure of dicot stem and monocot stem.